Hello everybody, welcome to the Chinese Lessons for Beginners by Linondina. Linondina is me, and I will present you today our 17th lesson. Don't forget to subscribe on the channel and to download the material that I put in the comments. Now it will be better that you have your paper together and see with me the lessons that I will present. Today we will make 3 points. The first is the tracing numbers from 1 to 10 in Chinese. This is a revision that we already made them. But now today we will trace it. And the second point is curiosity. We will speak about E, that is 1. And the third point is tracing 4 new characters from 16th till 19th from our amount of 500. So we can start. Thank you for watching me. And if you are interested to see something else in my channel, you can go and search for the playlist and see and choose what do you want to see. Now we can continue with our lesson. Okay, how to make to trace the characters? This is a revision. This is you can see, write on the one sheet of paper the name on pinyin of the numbers, and you can trace them. So you can say E, and you have to trace E, E, E. You can make one or two lines. Okay, this is easy, but after we can continue with R. This is number 2, and you have to make to trace it. The third number is sun, number 3. So we have to make it not equal, but a little bit to have some aesthetic. Okay, so S, this is a 4. We have to make first this, that is the vertical, after this, and after we have to design inside and to close. Okay, this is S, number 4. Wu, this is number 5. We start from the horizontal, after we make the vertical, after we make this, that is curved, and after we close. So this is Wu. Next number is Liu. Liu. We start with this, that is 1 dian. Horizontal, that is hen. And this is 1 pie, na. Pie, na. Okay. This is Liu, number 6. After we have to see Chi. Chi, this is number 7. So you start with this, even it's not 100% horizontal, it is called horizontal stroke. It's Han. Okay, this is was number 7. And Pa. Pa is number 8. So we have to trace it first on the left, descending on the left, and the next one is descending on the right, and this is number 8. Jiu, it's number 9. 9, we have to trace first this, that is descending on the left, and after we have to trace this. This is Hen, Zhe, Go. Hen, Zhe, Go. Okay. I said like this and like this. So if you have some doubts, you can go and see the animation on the Pleco. And shu, this is our, this was 9. And shu, this is our last number for today, that is 10. We start from horizontal and after we make the vertical stroke. Okay, that was our 10 numbers, the revision. You can exercise it home and trace it more lines if you like. Okay, now we will see curiosity. Curiosity in Chinese, one is the symbol of the unity of the entire, but also the origin of everything. For the Taoism, one is the sign of the absolute. The horizontal stroke represents one hand with the index finger that indicates one direction, like this. When it makes part of the other characters, the stroke occupies different places and changes even the meanings. In the next three characters is above and have the sky meaning in general. So in the third one and in the first one we can see that it's not only the sky. Okay, for example, in the word sky, that is Tian, this is the word, the character, sky, Tian. Tian, that we saw that it means so many things. It's not only sky, but means a day and the god and nature and like this. Indicates all that is above the human beings, including the idea of protection. Practically, this is the meaning of this is the sky. This could be the ground, because two means the sky and the ground, and because the character, if we decompose it, it will give us the R and Ren. We can see this is the R and this is Ren. And decomposing it. Okay, so the part above is the sky. Now we can see the next character, that is the rain, that is U. It's the third tone, so we can find it on the superior part of the character with meaning of the sky, on which we've got the cloud hanging up, which releases the small raindrops. This is the sky here, and this is the cloud with the raindrops. Okay, and this character means U. Third tone. So in the third character, that is one, that means emperor or king, meaning the king and emperor. Excuse me, please. Okay, this is the meaning. So what represents the Wang? Wang, it's not Wang. It's about represent the sky. This in above. This in the basis, it's a ground. And this in the middle represents the emperor. The emperor that links the sky with the ground during his reigning. Reigning, I speak it. This raining. Okay. Meanwhile, he's on the throne. Okay, this was the curiosity for today. And now we can pass on our third point, that is tracing the new four new characters. So the first one is Da. This is the fourth tone, and how we trace it. We make first the horizontal, after descending on the left, horizontal, descending on the left and on the right. So this character Da, that means big, great, large. This is opposite to the xiao. Xiao is this. That means small. We can say that the second meaning is general, main, major, or of age, usually of a child or a youth, old, could mean old, old. So, it could be, this is like an adjective. Sin means adjective, sin ronts, and this is the second possibility to be adverb, that is the fu, foods. You can see the character on the material. That means greatly, fully, in a big way, on a big or large scale, with all out efforts, vigorously. We can read it also die. Die in the unique word that is die fu. That means doctor. And the same word, we can read it even dafu. Dafu, that means senior official. This is the person that worked in the imperial court. So, or maybe there is even now, even today, who knows. So, we can go and see the 17th of the 500. This is the character of Tai. How we trace it? We start with the horizontal. So we go on descending on the left and on the right. And in the end, we put our dian. That is the point or the drop, the name, dian. So, Tai, it's a fu, foods, that means adverb. It could be translated as excessively, too, over, excessively, too, extremely, or very. And when we put it together, too, Tai, it becomes Tai Tai. Tai Tai, it's a means, that means noon. It's a Mrs. Madam, mistress of a household. Madam, lady, or when preceded by a personal pronoun, is a wife. We can say qian tai tai. This is a money wife, money lady. There is the way to make the names of the Mrs. Okay, now we can go and see our 18th of 500. This is Chuan. You can see this is made by the same elements, but they are distributed in different places, so they changed the pronunciation and all. So, this is Chuan. That you can say Chuan. That means doc. That is means noon. How we trace it? We start with the horizontal, descending on the left, horizontal, descending on the left, on the right, and at the end we put the dian here. So, this is the name of the dog, Chuan, Chuanzi. We've got another word for dog, go. But this is maybe the more and the older word, I think. So when there is the word like example is Chuanzi. Chuanzi means my son. This is a noun, means it's dated or self-deprecating. And the last 19th from 500, it's the word for xiao. Xiao means small. It's an adjective, xin rong zi. How we trace it? Because this character have the middle, so the heart, we will start with the heart. We make this horizontal with the crochet. So we make the descending on the left and after descending of the right. So this is the character that is named Xiao, the third tone. So that means a small, little, petit, minor, opposite to Da. Okut means young, opposite to Da or Lao. In the last, in order of seniority, youngest. And it could be even the futs, that means adverb, that means of short duration for a while. When we say Da Ren, the antonym is Xiao Ren, Da Ren means even the big person, very famous, but could be even the generous person. And the Xiao Ren is not so generous and the opposite of the generous. So with this I finished my lesson. So I wish you have a nice good study and see you next time. Bye bye. Zaijian.